Here we are at Chicken Flag Automotive, Wongaree. Let's go check out the boys, see how they're getting on with the car. We're gonna make a back bar to stop blowing out the tail lights and wrecking the rear quarters. Just so something that when I come up to a wall, I can just glide along and just scrape it, you know, instead of it just folding the whole rear of the car in.
Crew chief lead as usual.
Yeah. Ready to roll. We're gonna give it a little touch up.
Should we have the top coat on in about 10 minutes, mate? No.
Oi! Oh! Stop it! It's covered, mate. It's good enough. Felt a bit, you know, bit shady, you know, going into that first corner and sliding down towards the wall. It was like, didn't feel too comfortable at the start of the weekend. Our gearing was a little bit, wasn't quite right, so we had to make the car slip a little bit more and push the car wider and make it flow down the wall a bit more. That took us a bit, like a couple of practices, you know, to set the car up and make it work, you know, because we didn't want to, just for that one corner, change the car for the rest of the track. I've done that whole heading towards the wall with on your driver's side, and it's a bit of a different feeling to what we're all used to in that. But once you sort of set the car up, you gotta 100% commit to the entry, you know, and just pitch the car in. And once you're pitched in, you just glide down. Pretty, I was going past it, I'm looking at the wall, like, oh yeah, trying to just back it in, trying to get closer and closer. Just hard to explain, you know, like how it was just an awesome feeling, you know, like to, it just felt like I didn't have any weight on my shoulders, like right from maybe, right from like the first battle, you know, and then every battle after that, it was just coming along easier and easier. We were just so happy with the way the car was performing, and the crowd was going hard. You know, every time we entered, it was just on the edge of their seats waiting for, you know, someone to just push it that little bit too far and end up in the wall. In those finals on that day, I wanted to go chasing hard, you know, like Swift Slim and Zach and Nico and that, you know, like those were real hard out battles. And then we came into that one with Redwood, and I was like, the boys are like, man, he's fun, you know, just play it safe, you know. So, but he got away from me on the takeoff, so I wasn't going to be able to catch him anyway. So I just sat back and Sunday drove it through and top set of the podium.
You've done a double podium.
Yeah, man.
You're on form. You're back.
Banger's back. It's a good feeling, amen. You know, just the car's, it's just falling apart as we speak, you know. But when I drove in to park up for the podium, it just, the clutch stuck down. It's had its day, you know. It's done the job, got us through, and it just stopped right there. So we're pretty lucky. But I wanted, everyone was telling me to, you know, do a victory skin and that. So I just did it. I started it in gear, got it going, and did a couple of donuts to get it on song, and then let it have it through here. And I couldn't see where I was going, so I was just trying to feel the wall, and it was good fun.
Put your hands together, Castro Legends, Mr. Fan Out There. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for the top three. Gaines Bay Park,
Well, Mike T, being it ends, mechanic, life coach, team manager, I guess. Sort of know all the ins and outs of the cars, all the race day procedures. Well, see, he got quite a list. The gearbox was quite worn going into the round, and it finally needs a bit of a rebuild, so that's being sent away, getting a straight cut dog's head on it. The clutch has done over a season now, and the last victory burnout, it had enough. We're replacing that, as well as the clutch slave cylinder and master cylinder, as well as the usual panel work. Round 4 at Hampton Downs, one of the biggest changes we'd make would be the diff setup. We'd run a 3-4 ratio diff, so we can hold third gear around the whole corner. And there's quite an elevation change as we come over the top of the hill. So you've got to really put the power on to get it through that corner and through the switch. We also changed the weight transfer characteristics. So when we're at the bottom of the hill, we can get that transfer onto the back wheels, get the power down, and get our speed up so we can clear it across the hill. We haven't even tested the Trias tyres at Hampton Downs yet. So with the things we know already, hopefully we'll be able to come in and look at different pressures and different setups depending on the day, the temperature, and stuff like that. So good. Good to see. Practice. That's what we want. Ha ha.
like the championships in the back of my mind, you know, the whole time, you know, but I guess there's a lot of pressure off at the moment, and we've got a good lead, but it's a long way to the end, and we want to keep going, and my goal is to just keep qualifying good and try and get to, you know, onto the top step of the podium and just have fun and be out there putting on a show. It's just the more feedback that I'm getting at the events, my friends and family and the followers and stuff like that, you know, like that's a real big boost for me. You know, that's what makes me go out and feel comfortable too, because you've got so much support and you're just going out and you're doing your thing and you're just so relaxed. It's awesome, man. Like, I'm just having a ball. It's cool.